2 News at 6.
And I hit the button on the video, and it just is driving, and I just, like, gasp. And I'm like, she was a real girl.
This is all Denise Higgs has left of her daughter.
I'm so used to seeing her like this now. Like this. Just over and over. That's all I have.
Pictures and memories of Autumn. Just 16 years old when deputies say her boyfriend shot her in the face.
She's not awake.
Is she breathing?
Everything is like divided in before Autumn and after Autumn. And I could talk about Autumn all day.
And for the first time, she's sharing her grief.
They've been running around free for 2.5 years while I suffer.
And her struggle for justice.
They've had all their birthdays, all their... So...
Autumn Higgs' boyfriend Hayden Wick and his mom Lori were supposed to go before a judge today to enter pleas and be sentenced for their roles in the teen's death. Instead, Autumn's family will have to wait another day to learn their fate. Thank you for watching NBC2. I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Kelly Burns. Autumn's mother has waited 2.5 years for the sentencing of her daughter's accused killer and his mother. And tonight she's talking to our Samantha Servin about her fight to get Autumn justice.
Bright and fun, energetic, smart, driven, kind.
That's how Denise Higgs wants people to remember her only child. 16-year-old Autumn Higgs, a vision in grace and loveliness, a young lady who had it all.
And I could talk about Autumn all day.
As she thumbs through hundreds of pictures, Denise is now left with only memories of her girl, who graduated high school and started college just as she got her driver's license.
I'm so used to seeing her like this now, like this, just over and over. That's all I have.
Take a deep breath. Is she awake?
No, she's not.
She's not awake?
She's not awake.
Is she breathing?
March 31st, 2021. Autumn is at her boyfriend's house in Englewood. Two guns laying on Hayden Wick's bed.
As far as the statements go, Hayden Wick stated that he pointed the gun at Autumn and pulled the trigger and said, "This is how you clear the chamber," apparently thinking it was empty.
It wasn't. A bullet pierced Autumn's face and killed her.
Oh, he stated later that Autumn probably loaded the gun. So, in other words, if he said that Autumn loaded the gun, then Autumn would have had to know that when he came out of the shower, he was going to pick the gun up and point it at her and say, "This is how you pull the trigger." Like, how would she know that?
Originally deemed an accident, it took investigators 10 weeks to arrest Wick for manslaughter and his mom, Lori, for allowing him to have the firearms in the first place.
There's three number one rules. Never point a gun at someone, never pull a trigger, and always assume a gun's loaded. And so there's other statements out in these court statements that said Hayden had gun safety training at an early age. So he violated all three of the basic gun safety rules.
Both Wicks are out on bond, scheduled to face a judge for sentencing 4 different times now, only to get delayed time and time again.
That's the most sickening part, that they've been running around free for 2.5 years while I suffer and suffer every holiday, every birthday, every Christmas. Fall is a really hard time. Halloween, we loved. We did everything.
As family thumbs through photo albums in a Venice hotel room, the hope is this is the last time they'll have to travel for the case. And after 2.5 years, have justice served.
I'm hoping it's going to go where they get very strong sentences, because I've been given a life sentence without Autumn. I have a life sentence. She's got a life sentence. And if they get small, light sentences, I'll be really, really distraught. So I'd actually like to see Hayden Wick and Lori Wick's picture on a billboard with their mugshots saying, "Learn from our example and don't get buy guns for minors."
One of the things that Autumn's grandmother told me today is a motto they've been using to push themselves through this entire journey, and that motto is "Until we meet again." Kelly?
Your heart just breaks for this mother. I mean, she's been through so much, and having it get postponed and postponed and postponed, I can't imagine. Any indication of problems in this teenager's relationships in the past? Has that come out at all?
So before this all happened, the family didn't know of any problems in the relationship. But after Autumn's death, her friends actually came forward and told her mother and her grandmother that Hayden had laid his hands on her before, bruised her, and even choked her. It's something they've now told deputies and will be involved in tomorrow's decision. I'm live and local in Punta Gorda. Samantha Serban, NBC2.